I am going to see what this is all about. All right, so I'm just going to set up here, I guess.
Ryuga Gotoku, 15-year Kiren Tokuban!
Hey!
さて、本日はですね、龍が如く15周年を盛大にお祝いします。生放送となっています。15周年おめでとうございます。ということでですね、その15周年を一緒にお祝いしてくださるのはこちらの皆さんです。それでは中谷さんから自己紹介をお願いします。はい、龍が如く錦山明役龍が如く7、
春日一番役中谷和弘です。よろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いします。15周年おめでとうございます。よろしくお願いします。さあ、続いて黒田さんお願いします。はい、龍が如く真島五郎役宇垣秀成です。いやいやいやいや、黒田。元井桐生和真役黒田孝也です。よろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いします。ありがとうございます。続いて名越さんお願いします。はい、龍が如く
総合監督の名越と申します。今日はよろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いします。さあ、続いて佐藤さんお願いします。はい、龍が如くスタジオプロデューサー佐藤大輔です。よろしくお願いします。お願いします。そして横山さんお願いします。はい、龍が如くシリーズ中プロデューサーの横山雅義です。よろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いします。
ということで、もうコメント欄もすごいことになってますよ。すごいですよ。海外からもね、たくさん英語でコメントも寄せられてますけど、ありがとうございます。Thank you everyone。緩めのご挨拶です。すいません。最後まで見てください。さあ、ということで本日はですね、15周年を年表で振り返りつつ、龍が如くシリーズの最新情報やこれから発売になるグッズも紹介していきます。最後までお楽しみに。 そして 12月 2日から始まりました 151.5時間生放送も佳境に入っているということなので、ぜひ2話で一緒にご覧になってください。よろしくお願いします。またですね、この後鬼越トマホークのお二人とも中継をつないでいきますので、今元気にしてらっしゃるんですかね、大丈夫かな。元気にはしてるでしょ。元気かな。<笑> この音が鳴ったということは中継がつながってるみたいで、ちょっと様子見てみましょう。鬼越トマホークのお二人。元気じゃなさそう。いきなり止まってる。元気じゃなさそう。あれ、画面フリーズしてますよ。あれ、ちゃんと映らないで。生中継ですよね。じゃあ酒井さん、録画とかじゃないですね。大丈夫。いきなり、いきなりかな。後ほどですかね。
よきところでまた触れていきたいと思います。マジで焦らすな。15周年。いや、さすが15周年。焦らすな。はい、まあ後ほどお聞きしたいんですけども、このね、生放送のもう一回立て直していただいて、
もう一回来ました。
よろしいですか、酒井さん、金ちゃん。
あ、今ね、今ゼロの一番いい。
なんで、もうちょっと待ってもらっていいですかね。もうちょっと待ってと。もうちょっと待って。はい。今、はい、今、桐生と、はい、真島が初めて出会ったとこで、すごく間が悪いんです。本当の最後のとこ。
見せてよ、見せてよ。
俺たちも見つ。あ、そうですね。見たいです。はい。最後のとこです。
はい。
いやいやいやいや。あ、今、桐生と真島会いましたんで、ありがとうございます。
全然、あれ終わったの？
何これ。ありがとうございます。今ですね、最終章龍が如くゼロ白と黒をクリアして、今我々3億円を獲得しました。クリアボーナスです。
お疲れ様でございます。
あ、大丈夫ですか。なんか怪しいですね、かなりね。大丈夫かな。はい、ありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。大丈夫ですか。はい。でですね、いろんなスタッフさんの、あ、映、今映ってますか。まだ映ってますよ。はい、後ほどですね、スタジオにも駆けつけていただきますが、Tシャツの方を忘れないでくださいね。
画面が止まってる。画面が止まってる。聞こえてはいるかもしれない、
ね。いや、そうね。めっちゃ面白いんだけど。
とにかく T シャツを忘れないようにって。
はい、それだけ。
高井ちゃん、T シャツ持ってきてね。
はい。
心配だな。
いい顔、いい顔。
いやいや。
この表情なんですか。
なんでここで止まったかな。
指名手配でしょ。
ちょっと電波がいまいち。
あれなんですよね。今回 151.5 時間放送で、はい、まあ、いろんなゲストの方に出ていただいて、
ね、
まあ、プレイをしてきましたと。で、今回、まあ、ナンバリングタイトル全部やりましょうってことで、1から、まあ、やっていったんですけど、はい、6まで行って、まあ、クリア早めにできたんですよ。
はい、
というわけで、あのプラス1で、龍が如くゼロもプレイして、なんかすごい画面になってましたね今、はい、龍が如くゼロまでプレイして、結局合計7作品、
わあ、ね、すごい、
この15年の間に出てきたものをやらせていただいたんですけど、ゲストで来ていただいた方とかにみんなにこう、うん、T シャツにちょっと寄せ書きというかサインをしていただいて、それを、まあ、リレーでここまで、持ってきてもらおうっていうことなんですね。
、はい
はい、鬼越トマホークが最後のアンカーだったので、
アンカーだ、
はい、このリレーの合計何人プレイしたのかちょっともう分かってないですけれど、
すごいです、まあ、中谷さんもそうですけども、本当に名古屋さんも佐藤さんも横山さんも結構スタジオいらっしゃいましたよね。
何度もいらっしゃって、
はい、
会社ですか、会社ですか、
入れ替わり立ち替わり、いろんな制作陣の皆さんが駆けつけて、もう紡いできたこの生放送、はい、ついに終了ということで、後ほどね、そのアンカー鬼越トマホークのお二人にもスタジオにお越しいただきたいと思います。お待ちしております。
ちゃんと持ってきてくれるんでしょうかね。
それ忘れたら意味ないですよね。アンカー
の取りに帰ってもらいますから。そう。
はい、ということでですね、本日はこちらね、15周年を年表で振り返りつつですね、龍が如くシリーズの最新情報などなどお伝えしていきます。で、改めまして龍が如くシリーズ15周年おめでとうございます。
ありがとうございます。
すごい、15周年ですか。ちょっとね、こちら年表ありますので振り返っていただきましょうか。これずらっと見せてもらえます。
お、
結構長いですよ。
うわ、長い。
細かいですね、結構。
いや、すごいですよ。
はい、2005年から伝説はスタートしました。あ、これカムロ町のアーケードみたいになってる。
そうです。あ、ね、そういうことね。
すごい、デザインもめちゃくちゃこだわりありますね、はいはい。さあ、改めましてこちら第一作の発売になったのがまさに15年前の2005年12月8日、本日の15年前ですね、発売になりました。これね、小ネタで言いますと、ドラマ極戦第一シーズン放送開始だったり、愛知留学、
その時代
に何があったのか、そうなんですよ、Yakuza like a dragon。
AKB48 と一緒なんですね。
AKB48 が活動開始でしょ。
そうです、そうです。
どんな頃だったのか、まさに12月にね。
Or I guess I should be saying Yakuza, I guess.
ざっくりなんですけど、
兄弟みたいなもんだったってことです。
全然違う。
そういうことですよね。
色が全然違う。
AKB はも
う iPod だよ、 iPod。
iPod。
Nishiki on the left and Kiryu on the right there。
あの頃ですね。これでも15年前ということで、まあ、流行語、小泉劇場、クールビズ、ブログ、ボビーマジック、萌えとか、
はいはいはい
はい
はいはいはいはい、そういったワードがありましたけども、改めてちょっと黒田さん、
はいはい、
龍が如くシリーズで桐生一馬を演じていらっしゃいましたけども、
はい、
初めてこうオファーが来た時ってどういう感じだったんですか。
いや、だから、
本当に、まあ、元々舞台とかテレビをやってて、うん、それで声の仕事を始めてからほぼナレーションをやり始めたぐらいだったんで、
はい、
そのゲームで声を入れるって意味が最初わからなかったぐらい、
うんうん、
の状態でしたね。
あ、かなり新鮮な状態
で、ね、あ、ゲームに声入れるんだ。それでちょっとした短いこう単語単語ぐらいの一行一行ぐらいのゲームはまだ経験あったのかな、
うんうん、
だけど今回それで龍が如くっていう作品で台本来た時にまず段ボール箱で来たんですよ。
段ボール箱、
段ボール箱
で、わー、怖い怖い。
段ボール箱で来た時に何じゃこりゃって思いましたよ。
そうですよね。
それから収録始まって、で、私はもう芝居を演じるようにリアリズムでやってたんですけども、はい、このセリフを終わったら次この格闘シーンに入るとかっていう最初ルールが分からなくて、
うん、
ここはじゃあ決めセリフにした方がいいとかっていうのも探り探り、うん、で、横山さんとかにこう、ここもうちょっとここから格闘に入るんで、もうちょっとこうその感じで煽ってくださいとかって言われて、うん、ああそういうことなんだって聞きながら、あ、じゃあここはリアリティよりも、ちょっとこう決めてった方がいいのねとかって 相談しながら作っていった感じで、だけどめくれどめくれど1ページめくれどめくれどこの束が減っていかないっていう記憶が
いやそんな分厚かったんですか。
はい、
わーすごいな。ありましたね。まあ、これ収録も本当に大変だったと思うんですけども、この名越さんだったりこの15年前この龍が如く作っていくぞっていうプランとかって、でももっと前からあったんですか。
プランはさすがに、まあ、もう気持ち前ですね。も
う15年以上前から。
15年だから発売から、まあ、2、3年3年はないか、
まあ、2年半前ぐらい、
2年半ぐらい前で、うん、まあでもそうですね、紆余曲折があって出てったんで
いろいろあって、
はい、大変でした、うんうん、
でもそのタイトルがこう発売された時ってなんかやっぱり異色なゲームじゃないですか、はい、人間模様だったりいろいろ設定とか、こうどうやって宣伝とかテレビ CM とか打ってらっしゃったんですか。
なるほど、まあ、テレビもしっかり打ちましたよ。だからまあ要はなんて言ったのかな、まあ、異色なだけに、でもど真ん中でこう宣伝をきちんとやって、うんうん、で、まあ、要は対策として売り出すことっていうのに結構やっぱこだわったんで、うんうん、やっぱりそこはまた逆に違和感も多分初めて見る方があったと思うんですよね、うん、
斬新
ですね。なぜこんなものがこう 大規模にこうやってるんだみたいなところが、うん、まあ、それも一応計算はしてたので、うん、まあ、結果的にはそれがまあうまい方に行ったというか、でも最初はね本当じわ売れだったんで、当時はまだ SNS とかねないですけど、あの本当口コミで広がってったんで本当感謝してますね。
いやもう初っ端から本当になんか濃い内容のエピソード聞かせていただいてますけど、ちょっと視聴者の皆さんもついてこれてますかね今日ねこれあの YouTube だけじゃなくてあの
視聴数超気になるんで
視聴数が出ないですね
さっきでもあのねライブ最後9000いくらまで、
うん、まあ1万、あとちょっとみたいなところ
で1万とかありましたけど、
それぐらいの方が待ち望んでらっしゃったということで、今日ですねあの YouTube だけじゃなくて、
あれなんか来たぞ、
中継がつながったようですね。坂井さん、金ちゃん、
はい、
今え、どこですかこれは。
うちの会社じゃねえか。
T シャツ着てますね。
T シャツ着てる、はい、ちょっとサインが
今から T シャツ送り届けるためにですね、
はい、
あのセガの本社からあのスタジオまでマラソンで行きたいと思います。
走ってます、
は
い、はい、行きます。あの間に合う24時間テレビみたいな体で
マラソンできる体型じゃないじゃない
膝壊しちゃうよ
大丈夫ですか。
大丈夫か、絶対インチキすんだろう。
近い、地下駐車場。
Something tells me these guys are trying to make it to the show but this is a freaking Yakuza. It's a sub story in the works right here. They're trying to make it to the show but they're late.
駐車場でも用意してあった
。嘘でもタクシー移すなっちゅうの。
しかもそれ芸者って書いてあるんじゃ
ない。Dude got all the autographs. He's gonna sell that shirt on eBay. And let me guess, I bet they're gonna have all the news. Future Yakuza. They could just tell us now, but we have to wait for them to show up to the show. Well, check back with them in a minute.
さあ、そしてですね、今回あの LED の方にご注目いただきたいんですが、スペシャルゲストの皆さんにいらっしゃって、
あ、すごい、すごい、お、すごい、イエーイ、
皆さん手振ってください、
あ、こっちか、こっち、
すごい、
みんな元気ですか、
Oh God, we're inside the Thunderdome。
関係者、
あ、本当だ、最後変わるなあの部屋みたいな、
すごい、
情報屋ですよ、皆さん。
覗いちゃうぞみんなの部屋。
恥ずかしい、急に恥ずかしくなっちゃう。
まあ、そんなこと言わない。プライベート覗かれちゃう。
ね、
あ、すごいすごい。
すごいなんか不思議な感じ
にされた。
見た顔もいるな。
いや、見た顔いますね。
います。言
うことは、は
い、いますね。
でも結構あのオンラインのイベントとかもやられてましたよね。
龍が如くオンラインのファンイベントとかファンミーティングとかやらせていただいてるんで、そこの参加者の方とか、いや、つい最近お会いした人がいます、ね。
本当ですか。
もういますね。はい。
元気変ないらっしゃったら
と。本当ね、女性の方も多いですね。
手振り続けてください。
ありがとうございます。
じゃ100人。
はい。
100人、
あ、100人もありがとうございます。
ありがとうございます。
そうですね、あのアンケートだったり。
For those that are wondering what I'm watching is RRG Studios and their big title is Yakuza, and I'm hoping for some information out of this. Going back to the many, many years of Yakuza here. All the way back to Yakuza 2. Didn't play the original, but I played the Kiwami. Which is essentially the original version, just slightly updated, slightly altered. Well, actually, I should say heavily updated and slightly altered. I think like some sub-stories were cut out. Haven't missed anything, have I? I would say no. I would say no. Not a whole lot. It looks like they're just kind of like just setting up. Just kind of like the whole history of Yakuza and all that. All I know is I see a graph of every Yakuza ever made by its year it was released. So I think they're just kind of like going over the history and all that stuff. I could only guess, but so far, to my knowledge, no major announcements have been talked about. So if you're talking about like any updates on the game, like for the series and that kind of type of stuff, you should be good. Should be good. I think you only missed like about under 20 minutes, more like 15 actually. So you're good. I'm thinking they're gonna save that stuff for the end. By the way, welcome to the stream, Grim. Yeah, I kind of like the beat 'em up as well. Same. The turn base was fine, but it just feels better as a beat 'em up, my opinion. Check my Twitter or YouTube. Well, actually, check my YouTube channel for the entire playthrough. It should be all up there. If anyone's curious about the Yakuza, by the way, I only played everything that was released on Steam, for the record. Dude, same. I set an alarm too. 100%. The only difference is I actually set my sleep schedule for this. I did set an alarm though. But it was kind of not needed. By the way, I appreciate all of you guys coming to my stream. We all Yakuza fans up in here, dudes. I only wish I knew Japanese so that way I could kind of like fill you guys in on what's happening. Like, kind of like if you played the series in Japanese subtitles and playing the game in Japanese and you're playing it without subtitles, that's essentially what's happening. on here. There isn't a closed caption. Yeah, there's no closed caption option. Feels bad. By the way, I might be spamming this message with this link. So, just in case if anyone wants to go to the actual stream itself, by all means. Otherwise, I'm going to be, like, talking over it and stuff. Oh, I should probably cut out the live chat. That's my bad. So, if you guys want to go to the actual stream, be my guest. But if you guys want to stay here with me, it's all good. Oh, 100%. Yeah, I want to see Yakuza 3, 4, 5, 6 all released to PC and Xbox. Hell, I would like it on every platform. I even want to see it on the Switch, and I don't even have a Switch. But who knows, the console wars of the 90s might be a little... Tension might still be there.
I'm
the exact same way. I don't understand one word of freaking Japanese. Except for the small bits and pieces. Like, hell, earlier in the stream, the one where we're watching, I heard somebody say Soka. And I was like, oh, someone understands something. Because from playing Yakuza, I always hear Soka. Oh, it means I see or I understand. But I'm hoping at some point we get like a trailer or something. Or like some images on screen of like, hey, this is, plans for the series, that sort of thing. But all the good juicy stuff, I bet they're gonna save for the end, which is fine. Oh, dude, Ishin will be awesome, dude. Ishin will be awesome. I 100% agree on that. I would love Ishin. Ishin, Dead Souls. I think that's what it's called, right? Yakuza Dead Souls? It's supposed to be like a zombie... somewhat canon to... canon in terms of like... I think it takes place in Kamurocho, you have Kiryu, you have Majima and all of them, but it's supposed to be like a fantasy, just using the characters and environment, but very similar to like how Red Dead Redemption did it. I think Red Dead Redemption did a like zombie, kind of like more like a horror type of thing. I'm trying to think. I'm also trying to. Was it Dead Nightmare or something like that? Anyway, Yakuza did the exact same thing. I'm pretty sure it was Dead Souls. Yeah, but it didn't release for PC, though. I know it came out for all you console guys. But I'm a PC guy. I'm only a PC guy because I put a lot of money into my PC, and I just... I mean, nothing against, like, consoles, because consoles have their purpose, man. We all grew up on consoles. I came from PlayStation, and after 3, I just kind of switched to PC. Have it on my show. Zombie game is fun, but the frame rate's horrible. That sucks to hear. By the way, they're showing off all the Japanese versions.
スピンオフ作ろうってなったのは何がきっかけだったんですか?
まあ、いろいろ
So just in case if there's anyone that got into Yakuza and they're like, hey, that doesn't say Yakuza. Well, it's called... It's basically what the studio calls themselves. Ryo Gotoku, I think is what their studio is called. Ryo Gotoku, something like that. I can't pronounce it, I'm horrible. I always just call them RRG Studios.
でいろんな選択肢を考えたときにじゃあ一層なんか、どうせ新しいハードでチャレンジするんだったら目先の違うものってのはどうだろうみたいなでその間にこう新しいハードの新しい表現をこうちょっと貯めてで、まあ、新しいカムロ町をお見せできるとこまでちょっと貯めながら、まあ、まあ今回はこの時代劇を一旦作る時代劇の方が簡単ってわけじゃないんですよ決して、
うんうん、
あとは横山が結構意外と歴史ものをすごく詳しいの で、ね、僕歴史ものが全くあれなんですだから鍵盤と維新っていうのは、はい、僕はシナリオに関してはほとんど、まあ、もう演出どうのこうので多少こうしたらみたいな話はしますけどいや
多少ではなかったと思うでもなんか鍵盤の時が一番揉めた記憶はあるんです話の
年はなんか
Love how they ignore the existence of the movie Funny thing, I thought I heard a friend of mine tell me that they actually have another movie coming out. It's either coming out or has, or it's in the works. But I was like, what, you mean that old movie from like, I actually think it came soon after or before the release of the first one in 2005. So it like released like 2004, 2007, somewhere in there. Anyway, it's supposed to be a movie about the original game, and I've seen it. And it's not too bad, but honestly, I highly recommend the game over the movie. But I thought my friend was talking about that one, and they were like, no, no, they're actually doing another one. I was like, oh, shit.
So.
It's good, but play the game. It's so much better. But if you're a fan and you just want to see, like, Yakuza done in movie form, last time I checked, it's still up on YouTube, I think. But... It's on YouTube somewhere, and it's like, it tells a story of the original Yakuza 1. It's good, but only fans of the game, I think, would appreciate it. I thought the guy who played Majima did his role pretty well. Everything was kind of boring, but Majima, same. Same dude, same. Majima steals the show. 100%.
したら名越さんがいやこいつ有名な人の方がいいなって言ってで同年代に生きてる有名人を探したんですよそれが宮本武蔵だったとあ俺も知ってるっていう
よかったよかった
よかった
でも、でもそれも普段なんですねどっちかっていうとね
By the way, if you guys need me to turn up the audio or turn down the audio, just let me know.
まあだから
I'll make sure to adjust it for you.
そういう感じで作ったんですけどやってよかったですよ。黒田さんどうでした？
いやまずもう映像がこんなに綺麗になるのっていうのが、
あれ綺麗でしたね。
進化がありますね。
いやびっくりしました。これ初めてやらせていただいた時、うんうん、もうそこがそこです
ね。Yeah, it should be good.
最初の印象
まず感動。
で、あとは単純にこの突然剣山に行ったってい
うのは、It should be good, but I thought I would bring that up just in case.
待ってたんで、
そうですよね。
やるとしたら。うんすごいなんかいつも裏切られるんですよこの龍が如くファミリーっていうのは
I'll just make sure to shut up when
出演者で勝手に予想してるんですよ予想してるけど当たったことがないんですよ、
まあそうですね、まあこれは当たんないでしょうね
そうなんそれで嘘つかれる時もあるんですよ
まあ確かに
それも次こういう感じのもの多分やると思いますよっつったら全然違う話だったりとかそういうこともあるんで基本ここのスタッフ信じてないんですよ
本当にでもいい意味で裏切ってきて、まあ、
そうですね、
その時代劇好きの人も取り込むことができたかもしれないですよね歴史が好きな方と
か、まあ、どうなんですか剣山つって3ですからね一応3にかけては見てるんですけどね、
う
ん
う
ん、
あそうえ
そういうことですか剣山って
ことですそれもあるんです
よちゃんと、はい、なんで今頃教えるの
出たこういうことですね
そうそういうことなんですよ
だからあの3っていうところに3が来てるじゃないですかちゃんと
えあそういうことだったんですか
名越さんがどうしてもあのびっくりマークをつけたいって言って
これこだわりなんだ。
これこだわりです。維新もついてると思うんですけど、
はいはい、
自覚とかも見てるんですけど、
ね、すごい。あ、なんかそういうネタが知れて新鮮ですね。
新鮮。
さあ、それを踏まえてのこちらですよね、はい、2009年2月26日発売、龍が如く3です。これもまたガラッと舞台が変わりまして、沖縄ですね。
あ、Yakuza 3, I want it so bad.
で、あの、沖縄舞台になりまして、桐生一馬が個人ひまわりの刑を行うなど、いろんなシチュエーションが加わりました。もうおじさんが本当におじさんになっちゃったみたいな、う
ん、I have a friend of mine IRL that actually played Yakuza 3, but I just didn't think I would be a fan of Yakuza, and then once it came out for PC, played Zero, oh my god, never look back. Never look back. I fell in love at first sight. It's the worst one out of the series. Well, they're gonna have a dud. You can't knock them out of the park, you know, 100% of the time. What really counts is having those golden gems in between. Because honestly, I think Zero is just something special. Zero was just perfect. Just absolutely perfect. The only thing I didn't like about Zero was probably the pacing. I have a streamer friend of mine who I really want him to get into Yakuza, but he just doesn't really like long games, and it takes fucking forever to finally have like the story pick up pace. Why is Majima in freaking chapter 2, for fuck's sakes? Put him in chapter 1. My friend would have fell in love with it immediately. But we gotta wait for like to the end of chapter 3 in order for like things to really take off. My opinion, by the way. My opinion. But other than that, like, it's freaking solid if you play the game.
で、まあ、うん、まあそういうのもあったんですけど、俺が一番きつかったのは風間。
Hey Andy, welcome man.
もう一回出したい。
Thanks for stopping by.
おー、そうですよね。どうするって。
Hope everyone set their alarms.
どうにかならないかって言われて。
By the way, I had to look it up.
いや、まあそれはね。
I searched 15th anniversary stream Yakuza. I'm the first result on YouTube. Why the hell is that a thing?
シナリオを書く立場とか、その演出する立場で思いつかないようなことを言ってくれる方なので、
It should be these guys. 言えないじゃないですか、
普通。そうですね。思い浮かばないですね。
そうなんですよ。でもやっぱ、
I always think I would be like the last result on the list.
まあだから、それは
微妙だな。
なんですか、ジョンウンと言っちゃいけないの？
いやいやいや。
まあまあ。
まあでもすごいことです。中谷くんずっと3だから黙ってますけど、維新まで出番ないで喋んないと。
そうそう、もうちょっとあります。
はい、中谷くん空白の8年の期間を言
いやいや、それはもう
3ってやりました、プレイした、
3やりましたよ。いや、もうそれこそ、いや、いよいよプレステ3で来たかっていう、だからやっぱ健三が外伝スピンオフだったんで、まあ、正当というか、ようやく本筋にまた戻って。
I just searched Yakuza filtered and live and saw you. Nice.
ええ、でも本当夢中でコインロッカー漁りまくったりとかしてました。あの、国際通りとかもう本当楽しいんですよね。僕も一回行ったことあるんですけど、本当空気感まで感じられるぐらい、本当に細かく作ってらっしゃってて楽しかったです。
結構リアルです。石垣の感じとかめっちゃリアルです。
いや、そう。
佐藤さん初ディレクター。
One thing that is a little awesome, seeing the panel, like I see a few guys that I'm familiar with, voice actors.
また黒田さんも龍が如く3には思い入れがあるというふうに伺ったんですが。
ああ、もうここはそうですね。いろんな。
Imagine we watch the whole thing and get no announcements.
That
would be a little sour, because then this is just for the Japanese fans, goddammit. Yes, I have no... If they put up subtitles, I mean, you know, that would help me at least understand what's going on. Funny moment, I know, right? We set our alarms, hoping that something would happen, and nothing happens. Did we just build up our own anticipation? No! Help!
このぐらいじゃそこまで乱れませんみたいな、最初そんな感じだったんですよね。だけど、いや、これはさすがに 俺の感情がここまで行くっていう、桐生も絶対ここまで行くっていう話をして、それで両パターン取ったんですよね、
はい、
あのちょっと感情を抑えたバージョンと、もうグラッと感情が出てしまうバージョンと取って、うん、それで横山さん信じてるからねって書いた覚えが
後押し
そう、あとはもう結局ディレクターとか作ってる側が、うん、それどっちを使うか選ぶのは、
I would be playing Yakuza like a dragon right now if it wasn't.
だけど、しつこいくらい信じてるからね。どっちを使うか。
The stream wasn't going.
すごいプレゼンを行ったわけですね。
I was actually playing a little bit of it earlier.
ただやっぱり、あの、
before the stream started.
くれましたね。
あ、やっぱり信じてよかった。
そうそうそうそう。
いや、まあ単純に。
I already finished it, but I'm doing a English playthrough.
その咳の音とか喉の鳴りと
か。I played it in Japanese first because.
ただ、やっぱ。
I'm just so used to hearing Japanese voice acting and thought, you know, get better voice acting and all that stuff. And then I wanted to do an English playthrough to kind of like, I wanted to actually compare it. And I would say the, so far from what I played from it, I think I'm up to chapter 7, I think, right now. And from what I played, I want to say the Japanese voice acting is better, but the English wasn't as bad as I thought it was. How's the dub? It's actually pretty good. It's actually pretty good. There is an actual reason to play Yakuza Like a Dragon. If for all those that did the Japanese voice acting, the English is not too bad. I want to say the voice actor for him, I kind of feel is a little off, but not so bad it takes you out of it. And plus, I've seen some of the voice actors of the cast. The guy that does do the voice of Namba, dude, it's a spitting image of the voice actor. I kind of love that about video games sometimes. I remember Grand Theft Auto was like one of the games I know that started doing that. And I really love that too.
沖縄をバックに。
沖縄かな？では、樽之助さんから質問があるそうなので。
But yeah, I much prefer the Japanese voice acting in just terms of like the quality of voice acting, but the English wasn't as bad as I thought. It's actually, from what I've seen, it's actually pretty good. But in comparison, I still want to say the Japanese voice acting is better. But that's just my opinion.
あのキャラクターがいっぱい出てくるんですけど、
はい、
その中であの上司にしたい人と部下にしたい人っていうのがあれば教えてください。
おお、上司にしたい人、部下にしたい人。
なるほど、
教えてください
。誰が答えればいいですか？
特にどなたに聞きたいとかありますか？名越さんに答えていただきましょうか。
あ、でもそう、
名越さんの上司に選ぶ人
聞きたい
で、ね、知りたいです。
上司面白いじゃん。
上司選ぶ今
タルムスケさんはこの後起業するつもりなんですか？
これ鋭い質問ですね、なかなか、
うん、あ、でも聞きたいですね。
名越さんにお答えいただきましょうか。
あ、答えは、
はい、
誰もしたくない
上司にも部下にもってことですか？
困るでしょ、だってこういう人
怖いですよね。なんかやらかしたら怒られそうだしな。
言うこと聞かなそうですしね、部下にした下で。
前島さんが多い、なんか YouTube 欄
嫌でしょ、前島は。嘘でしょ
嘘でしょ、嫌だな。
嫌ですよ、バットで殴られちゃうんですよ
そうそうそう、
皆さんそうちゃんと分かっておいてほしい。
そう、そう、
一番最初なんて
前島は部下をバットで殴ってんだからね。
そう、怖
っ。笑いどころやないかいって殴っちゃうんです、
ね、潰そうとしてましたからね。
ただ部下にミネがいたらちょっとお金儲けはできそうです。部下には持ちたい人がいるかも、うん、ただ最終的には悪いことしちゃうんでしょ。やっぱり困りますね。
困りますね、うん、会社的にめっちゃ困りますよ、ね、
悪いことする前提っていうのもまたどうなんだろうと思いますけどもね。
で、錦は裏切るじゃん。
誰もやっぱ誰もなのかな。
ゼロですよ、かわいいやつだったのに。
いや、ね、かわいいやつだった
のに。彼上司にしちゃったらもういけり打たれます。
The guy that does the voice of Kiryu, I really love the guy's style.
Kiryu Kazuma しかいないんじゃない。
あ、I love the hat.
いや、Kiryu は Kiryu でね、もう多分だって大門ぶ I'm
a man that likes his fedoras. That's why on my Yakuza Like a Dragon playthrough, I always Psycho and Uri. I always ran dealer with them because I love the fedoras.
セブンになってくるとニュアンス変わるかもしれない
ですね。でも確かにそうですね。てか社長ですしね、カズが。あ
もうでもカズがもう余計なこといっぱいして
くる。なんか選
べない。みんな癖強
い。いやまあそれ
は。イシキュースラッシュ一番。
そう。あでも当時は秋山さん。
Just now realize he's kind of sporting Ichiban style, white shirt, red jacket.
やっぱり基本お金。
He's a singer, fun fact.
Dude,
I actually seen him sing some of the Yakuza songs, and I was like, you ever see someone and it's like, you think they chose the wrong profession? Dude, like some of the singers for the Japanese music is so good. They're actually not just legit actors, but they actually, yeah, I did find that out myself as well. As some of these guys are actually like, they're actual singers.
次の質問に行きましょうか。はい、あ、じゃあここでユーザーアンケート行ってみましょうか。
Anyone else slightly offended that Kiryu's not rocking a black shirt or a red shirt and he's rocking a black one?He almost has Kiryu's look. He's just got a black shirt on.
Gesture.
He's got the gray suit part, but he should be wearing red. Maybe his favorite color is black, maybe.
はい、ヨーガゴトクシリーズすべてプレイしたことはありますか？
あるない。Voice actor is so good. Voice actor or singing? Yeah.
なかなかですよね。
A lot of the singers are just so good.
ゼロから七ということで。
I actually recently got into some Japanese music. There's this one band I just fell in love with called Wageki Band. Oh, they're so good.
まあ、ワンズはオリジナル版か極みどちらかでプレイしてればプレイ済みということにしてください。
Wageki Band, Bandmade, Love Bites. I turned weeb. Thanks a lot, Yakuza! You turned me into a weeb. Hey, I'm proud to be a weeb. Join the weeb army.
YouTube の方もね、いろいろあるあるってナンバリングならあるよって
大丈夫ですね、全くないっていう人いないですよね。
何アンケート集計中、誰か数えてくれてるのこれ。
Sorry if I keep yelling.
野鳥の会
話。そうですね、日本野鳥の
会話。 I just get excited.
紅白の集計みたいな
集計していただいております。見た感じ丸多いですね。あ、すごい、なんか結構背景注目してみる、
うん、いやなんかこうファンの方とかにゲームショーとか、まあ、そのサイン会とかでお会いした時に話聞くと、うん、あの流水入りの人とか結構いるんです
よ。 Fell in love with Crazy Can Band thanks to the OG Yakuza 2.
ヤクザの話だと思って敬遠してたけど、
Freaking Yakuza man. They're turning us. They're all turning us.
すごい感動した。でそっから
They want us to all listen to freaking Japanese rock bands and pop bands and shit.
違うんですね、人によって。で長い歴史あるとやっぱ
It's because they do fucking good music, dude.
なんかサザンオールスターズでどのアルバムからファンになったみたいなあるじゃないですか。でそれに近いこう感じは出てると思うんですけど。
フリーから女性ファン増えた気がする。
そうですね。
あ、そのタイミング。
That's like the only thing I hate about DMCA laws. I would totally play a bunch of the music that I like on stream, but due to reasons, I can't.
それでは結果ご覧いただきましょう。どうぞ。
おすげえ。
ある84%、ない 16% ということは、ほとんどの方がナンバリングシリーズ全部プレイされてますね。すごいわ。いや、ありがたいですよね、本当に。
でもやっぱね、次から次やりたくなりますからね。今もう発売されてるものっていうのも、うん、
欲しくなっちゃいますよね。
ワンをやれば2やりたくなるし、うんうん、ちゃんとそういうあの時間軸とか系列とかも全部正しく行われてるからこそ、みんなねシリーズ通してやりたくなるんでしょうね。うん、
さあでは続いてまいりましょうか。じゃあちょっとこの年表の方に戻りましょうか。
い
続いてが
年表、あ年表、
はい、
年
表 Going back to the board.
戻ります。こちらです。2010年3月18日発売、龍が如く。
The friend that wanted me to play Yakuza, that's where he's at with the story. You played up until 4.
健算でもありましたが、本編としては、
Motherfucker kept spoiling shit, mostly because he thought I wasn't gonna get into it. But thank God a lot of it went in one ear, out the other.
また進化が出てきました、ね。
Yeah, I have an IRL friend that that's where he's at with the game.
出演されてます。
その前の
顔出しは前からあるんだよね。
剣山から
剣山からあるんだ
よね。そうですね。
Oh, he actually has a legit band. Called the Goodfellas. Nice, dude.
多くなってくるっていう。今もなおすごい人たちだらけですね。
そう、改めて見ても。
改めて見ると、よくやったな。
That's actually kind of similar to. God, who was it? There was an American actor I had no idea started a band. God, who the hell was it? Yeah, it was Joe Pesci. I recently discovered that Joe Pesci actually started a band. And surprisingly, In Goodfellas, the guy he kills in the trunk of the car, and later in Casino, the same guy that kills Joe Pesci's character, I actually think he did the voice of... Oh, crap. What was his name? God damn it, he also did a voice in GTA. Crap, I'm drawing a blank. It was like the Corleone family. I just know him as Phil from The Sopranos. Anyway, that guy, they started a band. And it's actually, there is a song that is actually really good, but I forget the name of it. Kind of like jazz rock a little bit. Anyone that's a fan of like Cowboy Bebop, you might be into it. It's kind of crazy how there are like legit actors who they legit like, and I think Joe Pesci, I think he actually plays guitar, which even, yeah, very impressive. You're known for your acting, but yet you also could like you have other talents as well. Salvatore Leone, yes! That's it. Yeah, that's who I was thinking of. Salvatore. Yeah, I was drawing a blank and I was like, I should know this freaking name. Yeah, if anyone's just tuning in, we're kind of watching the Yakuza 15 anniversary. They seem to be going over the entire series. It's kind of all done in Japanese, but I'm kind of hoping, crossing my fingers, that maybe we'll get like some images and hopefully some logos and possibly a date, and we'll be able to make out. Okay, so it's on this day, this month, this year, potentially. So far, no announcements. Just a lot of talking in Japanese, and I don't understand a word. But just like the rest of you guys, I also set my alarm and all that shit, so we're just waiting for the news.
やばそうだなっていうのは、まあまあ、
もう無理じゃねえのかな。
まあ、作る側の問題です。ごめんなさい、それは。
Hey, welcome!
そんなリアルなお話聞けて嬉しいです。
XYZ?
それはそうなんだけど。サブタイはね、なんか時に名古さんがつけよう。
Yeah, so far, no major information.
しようって言われ、言って、ただね、あんまりね、説明されなかった気がするんで、覚えてないですよね。
もう誰も突っ込まなかったんですか？
突っ込めないでしょ。
いや、ですね。
ねえ。
うん。 まあ、本当に名越さんがもうこれでっていう風につけられた。
でも多分いろんな思いが入ってるんだと思う、はい、それ以降はまあ分かるんですけど、うん、サブ隊の話は、
うん、Goodness in that band on YouTube you can search、
はい、ということ
で一応伝説の竜で I'll look it up、うん、Thank you for that
主人公たちはそれを告げるぐらいの
Yakuza Zero is the best It's my favorite so far. I don't want to say it's the best in the series until I actually play it for myself. But so far from what I played, it's my favorite.
中継がつながったようですね。
鬼越トモロクの
お二人、どこいるんだ？
I'm hoping these two guys are the guys that are going to deliver us the information.
すいません今ちょっとあの空き時間あったんであのポッポと M ストア行ってタウリナを買ってました。
So I'm guessing that these guys are late to the show. They're trying to show up. So guy on the left got a T-shirt with a whole bunch of freaking signatures. He's probably gonna sell that off of eBay. But I'm guessing these guys got the information that we want to hear about announcements. I'm crossing my fingers for it. I mean, they could just tell us now, but kind of like a sub-story bit. They're late. They're in a taxi. They're going to be here any minute with the news. They stopped at the Popo freaking store, picked up some snacks, and they should be here any minute. It's gonna take them like 2 fucking hours to get across Japan. I'm hoping those guys have the information, goddammit. Make it happen! But yeah, Yakuza Like a Dragon's pretty good.Story-wise. Yakuza Like a Dragon's pretty good. I really liked it. 2010年9月22日発売黒豹龍が如く Not... The turn-based is completely fine with me, but something about the beat-em-up style I think is just better. This is my, in my opinion. I could live with the turn-based, but it just feels better as a beat-em-up.So I wouldn't mind if they have the Like a Dragon series be like the turn-based and have like Yakuza as like the beat-em-up. If they do it like that, I actually think I would be fine with it. Because then that way if fans are not like really into the turn-based, then you just wait for Yakuza Like a Dragon 2.And then if you like the beat-em-up, you know, you wait for Yakuza 7, so to speak. I wouldn't mind if they have like a turn-based version, but me personally, I like the beat-em-up. Black Panther. You need that release in the West, absolutely. Gotta say, 045, Like a Dragon are definitely the most complete Yakuza games, while others are lacking some content. I could see that. You know, it's not gonna be perfect every time. Yakuza 8 continue with Ichiban as the party says...Replaceable. That's the thing. At the end, without going into spoilers, because just in case if there's any lurkers who haven't played Yakuza Like a Dragon, without spoiling the ending at all, I will say I did get a sense of like what potentially could be the next for the series.And from what I saw, it was good to decent, from what I saw. But that's just my opinion.
Yeah, you're good, XYZ.
親父の方は分かってんですけど、あの、 行き別れの親父さんで、うん、親父さんは一目でもう自分の子供って分かるんだけど、かつて自分がめちゃくちゃ人間だった時とそっくりな息子を見て、この子だけはちゃんと教えてやり、何かまともにしてやりたいんだけど、自分が伝えられるのはもう戦うことでしかないから、戦うことで一回一回テーマを決めて彼を育てていくみたいな、そういう話にした。
またでもこの若い世代に伝わるようにといった、その主人公もちょっと年齢若くなってますけど、実際にこう反響といいますか、買ってくださった方
が That would be kind of interesting.
多かったと思いますね。だからこれも結構初代の時と全く売れなかったらどうし
よ
う。
That would be kind of interesting, interesting XYZ.
でもなんとかなったんで、でも嬉しかったですよ。
そうだったんです、はい、
ドラマにも最後していただきましたし、
は
い、
そうですね、斉藤工さんが出演されてました、はい。さあでは続きのタイトルに行ってみましょう。続いてが、はい、こちらでございます。こちらが2011年6月9日
Oh, they're even covering the PSP releases.
キラピース3のタイトルですね。もうこれもなんで敵をゾンビにしたんですか。
Of the end, I think that's the zombie one. I'm not mistaken.
ゾンビは俺の案じゃないんだよね。
I want to say that was the zombie release.
あら、
Maybe.
いや別に逃げてるわけじゃない。
It's always different from the Western audience and the Japanese.
実は、まあ、パークスタイルっていうか、要は、ジュラシックパークもそうですけど、まさにパーク。
Of the end, I'm pretty sure that was the.
その中で何かが起きるっていうのはゲーム的に。
Pretty sure that was the zombie release.
まあそういうドラマとかあるんですけど、映画とかでも昔ユニバーサルの記念作品でバトルシップなんてのもありますけど、あれもなんかバリアが張られて、結局その中で空軍は手が出せないみたいな、海軍とで陸軍は陸軍でなんか別のところで戦ってみたいな、まあいい話なんです。
It would be interesting to see them release Dead Souls and all that to like Xbox and PC and all that。
ぶっちゃけて言うと宇宙人だった。
宇宙人。
宇宙人。エイリアンと戦う。
なんかそれ聞きました、
うん、はい、で当時のプロデューサーの菊池がゾンビだ絶対っていう話になって、まあそのやっぱ
That almost looks like a short barrel 50 cal、
まあ、どっちにしても SF っちゃ SF なんですけど、まあ、最終的にはゾンビで正解だったなとは今でも思いますけどね、うん、
なんかあのグネグネ動く感じとか、なんか腕かじられちゃうみたいなシーンが結構衝撃、衝撃というか、
ああいうバイオレンスさはやっぱその宇宙人じゃやっぱ結局はうまくできなかったと思うんで、うん、だ僕はあの桐生一馬に人の星に土足で踏み込みやがってって一言言わせたかった。
あ、それって本編中そのセリフあるんですか。
いいセリフだ。
これあるんですかそのセリフ。
ないない、
あ、ないんだ。
宇宙人バージョンだったらって。
宇宙人だったら絶対それを言わせたかった。あ、
そうか、ゾンビは別に土足で踏み込んでないから。そうそうそう、
これいいなって。
あ、そうだったんです。ちょっと気になりますけど、
ただその一言のためにね、あの中身決めちゃダメなんで冷静にこうかちゃんとエンターテインメントとしてできるようにって考えて、
だからまあ開発スタッフ的にもオブジェエンドをやったことによって、それまでまあ言ったら近距離強打というかフルコンタクトなアクションばっかり作ってたわけですよ、うんうん、龍が如くって、はい、でそのシューター的にというか何かもう弾を当てるとかってゲーム的な制御でいうと全然別の作り方だから、うん、そのやっぱ一回こういうことをやるとその作品がどうこうだけじゃなくて未来は広がるんですね。でやっぱ俺らって技術がベースにあるんで、やっぱそういうのを踏んでいかないといけないっていうのは常に思う。やっぱマンネリズムとの戦いなのは間違いないんで、うん、シリーズものっていうのは、はい、うん、なのですごく旗から見てて、僕まあ5やってたんだけど先に旗から見てて、あ、いいチャレンジしてるなってすごいこう思ってました、
うん、そうだったんですね。
俺は裏で作ってみたいな。はたから見てて、うわぁ、作りづらそうだな、これ。
そうだった。難しいと思
い
ますよ。龍が如くファンがついてきやすい、まあ、いわゆる簡単な操作感で習慣を実現するって、すごくこう相反することをやろうとしてるわけだから、うん、でも多分名越さんはガチャプレイというかその龍が如くのファンを裏切らないことに多分操作感もこだわったはずだし、うん、ってなると
My apologies for
超難しい操作
じゃない、 not knowing too much about the series for 3, 4, 5 and 6
やっぱ思いましたけどね。
Have you had to play those?
時代背景的
には結構大変でしたよ。
大変だったんですか。
大変でした、
ね、I'm a white fan of Yakuza。
の下りとかも結構割と後で考えてなんかやりたいな。
そう、
自分のたこ焼き屋の師匠が タコのわけになるんだけど、うん、ここはなかなか倒せない倒せないんだけど、
ワードだけ聞くとすごいな。
ふと師匠が昔タコの締め方を教えてくれたくだりを思い出して、うん、急所はここだっていうのを思い出すっていう、まあ、これもくだらないんだけどでそのなんかムービー作れっ
つってこの間岩崎さんがその話してましたよ。それでタコの締め方を覚えた
それで覚えちゃうんですね。
Yes, from this year, I'm a huge fan of Yakuza. We all are, dude. We all are. Honestly, we are up like 4 in the morning. Well, at least for me right now, it's 4 in the morning. We wouldn't be up at this hour if we didn't like Yakuza. Just saying. So, we're all here because we love Yakuza.
お店でキャバ嬢役で立花ゆりかのもうフェイスキャプチャー、フェイスキャプチャーもやらせてもらってもうなんか。
Because I'm sure like a lot of you guys probably know who Devillian is.
Like,
I'm aware of him. And there is plenty of videos I would love to see from the guy. But I realized there was like one video I came across of like, well, without going into spoilers and all that stuff, the guy actually said, make sure that you watch Yakuza 3, 4, and 5 if you want like the full detail without spoilers. And I was like, shit, I can't watch that. So there was like a video and he was like going into stuff. It is really awesome how he breaks down stuff. But like, out of all the people who love Yakuza, why does it feel like I'm the only one up at this hour actually doing this shit? Everyone else is gonna do a YouTube video, like, get their opinion of like what happens after. Meanwhile, I'm streaming, like, I'm streaming and doing this like a real fan would. We'll wake up and we'll just stream the shit and just see what happens. Be here live.
だけどなんかそこは僕はマノジャクなんでなんか
Zabdo's channel legend gameplay and memes absolutely
衣装合わせで彼に初めて会って
even though I haven't really watched any of his content like he it is awesome how Devillian does do some of his videos I'm fully aware of that like God damn it I could be wrong on this Because I might be confusing him with someone else, but there, I think it's Devillian who he actually is. I think he actually is Japanese, or at the very least, like he speaks the language, and he actually does get the Japanese release, and sometimes even like compares the Japanese version to the. English for you.
12月6日発売龍が如く5夢叶えしものですこちらまた5大都市で
But that is like freaking awesome.
今回 151.5 時間放送でやって分かりましたけどこれは化け物です
Yakuza 5 another game that I want to get but can't reasons
because
I'm waiting for a PC release but then again I wouldn't mind seeing it on Switch either it'll be awesome Honestly, if they expand to more platforms, more eyes on the product, I think it would be good for RRG Studios, but also for the series as well. If they do more platforms. What do you think they will make a Yakuza 0.5, like a story in between Zero and Kamami, where Kiryu and Majima are actually... Actually, in the Yakuza, doing Yakuza business, what are the chances? Honestly, believe it or not, I actually had a conversation with a friend of mine recently, and we were actually talking about that. What if there was a Zero? Like, what if there was a version of Zero, like, before. Before Kiwami or Yakuza 1 and like after the events of Zero and honestly for me it wasn't so much of between Kiryu and Majima it was actually more of Kiryu and Nishiki and building up that bond Because, again, I don't want to go into spoilers, just in case if there is anybody that hasn't played Yakuza 1. But if you know the story that takes place in 1, especially if you played Yakuza Kiwami 1, you know how that story is. And you got this bond between brothers. How awesome would that be if they did a version to where they actually talk about... They do a version to where it's almost like Double Dragon to a degree, to where you got Nishiki and Kiryu like working side by side, and you got to see that. And I'm sure they would work out a story to where Kiryu is out of the Yakuza again, because for some reason this guy could just never be in the Yakuza. But I think it would be a great story if they did a story of Kiryu, like seeing signs of like, is this the life I really want to live? And I think that would be a great story. And it could... They could tell a story of just Nishiki and Kiryu being together and just have that vibe of like, is this the life I really want to live? And I think they could tell a great story of that. But who knows? But to add Majima, I mean, it's so hard to not add Majima to the conversation. He's so good. But I see what you mean, where you will probably want to see more of a Kiryu and Majima story. I don't know. That it would be interesting, but I don't know. Yakuza 5 is pretty cool. I just want to play it so bad. Especially now 6, because of playing... Because I'm actually really glad that I have someone like Andy hanging around in my channel, because like he's played the entire series all the way from the very beginning, and I know the experience that he had with 6 was probably a little bit more different than my experience, his experience with Yakuza Like a Dragon, since he played the entire series from the beginning. Me, I only played 0, 1, and 2, and then skipped right to 7, or Yakuza Like a Dragon. And I did feel there was a scene to where they basically straight up like reference Yakuza 6, and it did... I'm glad I don't know, but at the same time, I don't think I could enjoy 6 as good as if I hadn't played Like a Dragon, if that makes sense. And so I basically kind of feel like I got spoiled the ending to 6, but at the same time, I don't exactly know like what happens, so... And yeah, it's just that was like one little nitpick that I had, but I'm hoping that the next installment of the game, like, we're all done with like spoilers and stuff. I don't want to get spoiled. I play Yakuza Like a Dragon 2 and all of a sudden I get spoiled like the end of 5, and it's like, you sons of bitches, I can't win. I just need to freaking just buy a freaking console already and just play the rest of the series. I hate my life. But anyway. But yeah, I kind of feel like... I do have a feeling like that was kind of like the case.
この2人 の, その演じる時の演じ分けを教えていただきたいなと思って。
Well, of course, we gotta have Nishiki after Zero, and yeah, the story about Nishiki and Kiryu would be really great, but I also want to see how Majima would interact with Kiryu, their during their pro, during the prom. Yeah, because that honestly could also tell the story of like essentially how that relationship comes to be. So it would be kind of interesting to see how Kiryu, because at the end of Zero, we actually do see Kiryu and Majima meet legitimately for the first time. So like, it is going to be kind of interesting to see the story of the dynamic of how those two characters essentially interact with each other, because they... Well, I mean, again, it's like, I want to talk about it, but I also feel like I kind of can't, because, like, spoilers? because Yakuza 0 is so good. But it would be kind of interesting to see, like, if they ever, like, got together, if they ever had, like, an experience to where they actually talked about, like, the characters... in character, in game, actually talk about like the experience that they had in Zero. Like that would be kind of interesting. And it's almost like putting the pieces together, and then also just kind of like see that, because Kiryu and Nishiki, now of course, again, because I haven't played 3, 4, 5, and 6, I don't know that true character dynamic between them. So that's actually part of the reason why I'm almost kind of dodging your question. So like, it's not so much that I want to give my opinion, because I feel like the opinion I would give is not necessarily the same to someone that would actually have played the entire series. So, like, I only played 0, 1, 2, and 7, and I don't really know that dynamic of Kiryu and Kiryu and Majima. So, if I had more of an understanding of that relationship, I would have a better understanding of how those two would kind of interact. So, I kind of feel like if I do answer your question, I don't think it would be as valid to someone who actually really knows those two characters. So, yeah, it still would be interesting to see how Kiryu and Majima would kind of interact. Just seeing what would happen in a case of like after the events of Zero and before Yakuza 1. Yeah, because there is a pretty wide gap between those two. Yeah, it's from 88 to like 2006, so there's plenty of a gap to do there. Well, actually, no, I think it would be 88 and 2005, because 2005, that's when Yakuza 1 happened. Although it probably released in 2006 for the Western audience. Uh-oh. You pulled a hamstring. Quick, the guy needs a crutch. I swear to God, this is a sub-story in the making right here. I would not be surprised if these two guys are devs and they actually write sub-stories. Because this comes off like a sub-story. Okay, well, I guess they're showing up to the studio. You just know that those two guys, if you guys were here from the very beginning, it really did come off like those guys were freaking late to the show. And they have to, like, catch a ride to, like, show up. And I'm hoping to God that they give us the juicy information that we all want of, like, announcements. Are you guys on the PlayStation? You want to hear, like, a PlayStation announcement? And people like me, I want to hear, like, a Xbox and, like, PC release. Wait, what the hell was that?
Popo 寄ってるかな?
For a second there, I actually thought my like monitor screw up. But no, I think that was like a botched camera angle. Here you and Ichiban's my favorite protagonist. It's kind of hard to say no to that. Here you's classic and freaking Ichiban Kazuga, like he's potentially the future of Yakuza. And as a protagonist, I thought he did his job very well. I'm very curious to see what happens with Ichiban's story arc. I think it'll be interesting. What do you think of Nishiki as a playable character? That would be interesting. That would be interesting. Mostly because that was actually kind of very similar to what I was talking about earlier. I think because someone asked me a question, what do you think? Oh, they crossed the finish line! Yeah, there you go! They're finally here! You probably got an autograph of that store clerk at the Popo store. Okay, now that they showed up, do they have the juicy information? Or do we have to wait longer? I actually kind of want to see where this is going. Got a whole bunch of signatures. Pretty sure that's the store clerk right there.
Oh!
Is he wearing a long sleeve tee underneath? Is he gonna take that off and it's gonna show off the new it's gonna show off the announcement? That's how GTA 5 did their announcement for that's what Rockstar did for GTA 5. Some guy had like a temporary tat, he lifted up his sleeve and like that was the announcement. So yeah, we're doing like friggin' whatever. I'm thinking that guy's, he could have like a t-shirt underneath, and it might have the announcement we're all waiting for. Maybe. Uh-oh, it's breaking out to a fight. Uh-oh. Ichiban's gonna have to break it up.
ね、お二人とももうこの150一時間ね、一生懸命やってきたんですから、やめてくれよ、おい。一番のお願い。うせえな。お前、春日一番以外の代表作一つもねえじゃねえか。なんかやさんの顔。それで本当は思ってないと思うんですけど、龍が如くがなかったら何者でもないんで。大切に頑張ってほしいなって思ってるんだけど、ああ。
Oh, I guess Nishiki didn't, well, Ichiban didn't help. They're still fighting. Quick, we have to cut to our commercial break. Hold on, Kiryu's gonna get involved, holy shit! Kiryu corpsing.
だけど俺この間金ちゃんの店行かしてもらったけど実家ねこんな悪ぶってるけど お母さん言ってたよ
なんて言ってたんですか。
すごくも反抗期もなく、すごい親孝行ないい子ですって
言ってた。やめてください。黒さん、キャラ崩れるのやめてください。
そうなの。
カウンター合わせてきた、カウンター合わせてきた。
黒さん、あの金ちゃんの実家の食べログゼロの居酒屋。
いやいや、食べログゼロ。
あのね、やっぱり、はい、まずかったです。
ほら、やめてください。てめえ、
てめえのせいで黒さん余計なこと言ったんじゃねえ
の。おい、What cure you didn't help? Well, once they're done fighting, they're going to tell us the announcement. So I'm guessing he's a voice actor of one of the characters then.
2021年は炎上するなよ。
この表情は。この
表情。あの本当は思ってないと思うんですけど、芸風的に早くいじりたかったんですけど、あの現場的にダメだよみたいな空気出てたんで芸人困らせるのだけやめてほしいなって、はい、すいませんでした。
こちらこそすいませんでした。
いや素晴らしい。
これは僕らはもうファンとして言いたくなかった。はい、はい、
まあ、でもすごい。
ただ、はい、もう笑い、全て笑いに変えて16周年を迎えたいということで、
はい、そうですね、
はい、やらせていただきました。はい、はい、一応、はい、ね、あの
だ、はい、お前ちょっと言ってからテンパって。いやいやいや、大丈夫だよ。
言っちゃったみたいな。
大丈夫だよ。大丈夫です。あの、はい、皆さん、あのセガの株価上げて。
そこまで言ってるからやめろ。
これで、これで、は
い、There should be like about 40 minutes left of this.
ありがとうございました。ありがとうございました。お疲れ様でございました。いや
最高。
すごいな。
素晴らしい。
いや光栄ですよ。逆に
緊張して神々で。
本当に。
いや素晴らしいよ。
すみませんでした。すみません、さん。
ちょっと俺コメント見れないです。はい、そうです
ね。あのプライベートでも言わなかったことを初めて言わせ
た。So 40 minutes left。
すごいいいコメントあって。これぞ追い
打ち。I don't know how much they're going to be dicking around here, but.
そうだね。はい。
There's an announcement. They should be bringing it up any minute now.
三連発ありがとうございました。
If there's an announcement.
はい、じゃあ続いて参りましょうか。年表の方に戻りましょう。
はい、無理やり戻るね。
一個から鬼越さんも行くしかね。
さあここまでね、結構来たんで、ここからですね。
Unless they want to finish the timeline here.
2014年2月22日発売、龍が如く維新です。こちらプレステ4、3。
I guess they really want to finish the timeline.
ということで、まあこちらもまた歴史ものですね。さっきもあのお話ありましたけども、この坂本。
But yeah, before I was rudely interrupted by two guys fighting.
その歴史ものとして高いストーリー評価で。
I did thought that the it would be interesting to see Yakuza, like a tweener in between zero and one.And I think it would be interesting to see like how Kiryu and Majima would interact, but I think the better route would probably be Kiryu and Nishiki. If they were to do that, I can't imagine how they wouldn't have Kiryu, or excuse me, Nishiki as a playable character. Ishin? Oh, yeah. I heard some of the...karaoke from it, it's pretty good. But then again, it's Yakuza.
じゃあこれって言ったのがそれでした。
一心だった。
なんですけど、坂本龍馬の話だったんです、ただ単に。なんですけど、途中で坂本龍馬の話をそのまま作ってもなっていうのがあって、僕が坂本龍馬がもし新選組にいたらっていうとんでも設定で、まあ、作った。お話ではあったんですけど、もう名護さんがどんだけ歴史知らないかっていう。
So far, we haven't got any announcements yet.
ファイトを始めって名前なんですよ。
But then again, this could legitimately be like just a 15-year anniversary, and they just want to talk about it. But I'm hoping that there is an announcement. It just might come in late as all.
こんな偽名ないっしょみたいな。いや、これ実在なんですよ。これ実在なんです
よ。やばい、バレちゃった。
I'm hoping it's coming close. There should be like about...
オンパレード、これに
足らない。
そうですよ。
ええ。
いや、だから、
Probably about 25 more minutes, so... They could be wanting to finish this timeline and then eventually give an announcement. If they give an announcement. Because it would suck if we ourselves just built up anticipation that was not supposed to mean anything. But since it is, like, with the devs, the actors, you kind of, like, anticipate something. I actually never played Ishin. I know of it, but... Because I'm from the PC crowd, and I only played what was released on PC, which is 0, 1, 2, and Like a Dragon. So... I'm fully aware of Dead Souls and Ishin and a couple of their spin-offs, but this is one of those things. I want to see it happen to PC, so that way I could play them, but looks like for me to enjoy those games, I gotta get a PlayStation 4, it seems like. Plus my PlayStation 3 I think crapped out, so if there's any games for the PlayStation 3, which I think 3 is one of them, and 4, well, it looks like I gotta get a PlayStation 3 as well. Would have been funny if they were talking about a new game, but since we don't understand Japanese, dude, that would be the biggest meme ever. That would be the biggest meme ever. Yeah, we know a Western audience is watching, but yeah, we don't care. That would be the biggest meme right there. I mean, I can't blame them because they gave me so much entertainment just from Zero alone. I can't hate these guys. Remaster Collection has 3 through 5 on PlayStation 4. Oh, that's right. Yeah, they came out with the remastered. That's right, and that all released on PlayStation 4, so I forgot about that. That was kind of recent, too. I was kind of hoping that they would give a PC announcement about that as well. Do, like, a release on PlayStation 4 and then, like, just port it to PC. Would be interesting. But I am, even though I am part of the PC crowd, I actually would love to see the series on every platform. Switch, Xbox, all that. So that way more fans get a chance to experience the game and enjoy it. Because I think it's a freaking good series. I just played Zero alone and I'm sold. I have the oils, the candles, the works. I could get weird with it. Oh, yes! Yakuza 0, freaking good game. Freaking good game. I absolutely love it. Everything about that game is just perfect. The soundtrack, the acting, the story, the minigames. I've heard it be referred to as a minigame simulator, and that's not an understatement. Have you played Kiwami 2? Yes. Yes, I have. I have played Kiwami 2. Kiwami 2 is pretty freaking good. Overall, as a game, it is awesome. But I did feel like the story, though, everything was awesome until the end. I felt like it had a soft ending, if that makes sense. But anyway, that's just my opinion. There's a lot of cool combo mods you can customize, PC mods, not in-game. Interesting.
そこはちょっと考え方とかお芝居とかポジションがまた違ってたので、横山さんからガツンと一番最初の また言うお芝居の時にそうカツを入れてもらって、でさらにあのプレステ4発売日と同時だったんですよね、うん、あの維新の発売、はい、
I think Kiwami 2 had the best final boss really
そうそうそう、
I will say, when I played Yakuza 2 and I did get to the end, those bosses just kept freaking coming. I thought I beat up one guy, I thought it was done, and I get another. it was just one after another, and it just kept coming. It was almost getting to the point where it was like, so who is the official final boss? You know what I mean? For those that played it, I mean, that's how it felt like playing Yakuza 2. I finished one fight and then there's another one. I finished another fight and there's another one. They just kept coming. And I think one of them had a gun and goons. And I was like, ah!
そうですよ、
めちゃくちゃ面白かったです。
もうだってオチは決まってるわけですよ、はい、ワン極みっていう、うん、それをあれだけおしゃれにしてスーツの色だけであんな話を作るのか
コミュニー2 may have the best character final boss but it's so damn easy because Kiryu is so overpowered
大したことない
I know right
過去の話でしょ
ゼロは結構実は初動はそんなじゃなかったんですよ
あそうなんですか
やっぱスピンオフって思われる方も多くて世の中やっぱゼロっていうと過去編っていう感じするじゃないですかタイトルとかも悩んで
る On Legend he does a lot of damage On Legend I wouldn't be surprised if trashIf they ever do Legend, and I know they do Legend, I almost kind of feel like if you do Legend, even the trash mob should be doing a whole bunch of damage. I almost kind of feel like if you do Legend, you should almost do it on every single difficulty, and then do Legend. You know what I mean?It should be like incredibly hard. At least that's my impression of it. Or at least how it should be done. Whether or not that's actually how it is.
スッと入れるんですよね、うん、だからここがスタートになって今アメリカヨーロッパとかはすごいもう竜が如く
By the way, I should actually probably say that I actually do casual playthroughs to be honest
あ、そうなんです僕あの海外ターン
I know some people love doing 100%
横山が飛行機乗れないんで
and like take on like Joe Amand and that sort of thing I could just never do that kind of type of stuff. I suck at the disco. Most rhythm games I'm just terrible at. I don't know what it is. My brain's just not wired to do that. Perfect timing. And I know that's one of the things you have to do if you want to face a hidden boss.As far as I know, every Yakuza had a hidden boss, but you had to, like, do all the side stories and do all the... I forget what you have to all do. And I think with Yakuza Like a Dragon, I think you had to get your entire team to 99 level and go to the Millennium Tower. Because there's like a dungeon that you could go there and apparently they have that's where the hidden boss is. By the way, my friend Andy posted in my Discord 100%ing the freaking game. Goddamn legend, man. He actually took on the Millennium Tower. Wait. I should clarify this. I do technically have two Andys in my chat. I should clarify this.
頑張ってこうぜこれから。
Andy Lau is
今日は名前だけでも覚えて帰ってください。本当に言ったんですよ。台湾で。
本当に言うやつあるんです。
いやでもね、すごい本当に熱狂的に迎え入れてくれて、皆さんで。
But Legend in Kiwami 2 feels the same with Kiryu being overpowered, or some of the bosses has slow
fun.
Boss is like Ryuji in the original. Ryuji's as a tester combo attack. Oh, really?
では続いて参りましょう。続いてがですね、はい、こちらなんです。
Okay, so if they're breaking this down, are they doing the Kiwami releases too, or are they jumping right into Yakuza Like a Dragon? They'll probably do the Kiwami releases. I don't think we got to the Kiwami releases yet.
まあいろいろこうお話は来るんですよね。ヒットしてくるっていうのはありがたいことで、うん、まあ小説にしない、漫画にしないとかアニメにしないとかも含めて、はい、だからそのまあどっちかというとアニメとかうんぬんかんぬんっていうのは意外と僕はさ、まあ、まあ元々が CG ですから、うん、イメージが近くてちょっと違うっていうのを避けようと思って、実写に関してはまあ積極的にまあ映画好きですし、うん、でまあ舞台も当然ある意味実写ですから、まあまあ、そこはじゃあいいんじゃないみたいなところで、ただまあキャスティングとかは確かに文句は言いましたね。こうしてほしいとか、もっとこういうニュアンスの人はできれば避けてほしいとかいうのはで、ちょっと困らせたりした記憶もごめんなさいあります、はい。
まあいろんな要望があって、
はい、でも面白い舞台でしたよ、すごく。
あ、そうだったんですね、うん、
めちゃめちゃ
Ryuji has a swing attack and he'd slow. Maybe his is getting to him. Kiwami 3, please. I think the reason why they stopped, and this is just my guess, the reason why I think they stopped with the Kiwamis is it was getting close to the same engine that they used for Kiwami 1, and I figured they didn't need to make a Kiwami. Ah, there it is, Kiwami 1. So yeah, they are doing the Kiwamis. So we should have Kiwami 1, which is they're doing now, Yakuza 6, which I see right to the left. There should be Kiwami 2 and I think Yakuza Like a Dragon. Could be wrong on that. But yeah, I wouldn't mind a Kiwami 3, but I think if the original engine that they used for 3 is close enough to close enough to the engine they used for Kiwami 1, I think that's the reason why they don't do Kiwami 3. New game? That's what we're hoping. We haven't got any new announcements yet, but we're praying like hell it is. Otherwise, this anticipation was built up for absolutely nothing. Technically, they never said they were going to really announce anything. They were just going to do a 15-year anniversary. But then again, I forget what article I saw to where I read that they were going to be doing this today.
さらに表現も上げていかないと本当のリメイクって言わないなと思って、まあ、頑張ってやってみようって感じで、まあ、やったんですけど、
well, I'm very interested to see if there is an announcement.
それもあったけど結構こすってた
から I'm praying like hell there is.
なんですけど、まあ、非常にこれですねご好評いただいてです
、so、I freaking love the series. It's so good.
まあだから本当に自分たちが作ってきたものってすごいんだなって改めてちょっと思わされた、うん、僕たちの方が信じれてなかったリュウワンを多分、うん、リメイクってもの
を、うんうん、そうです
だと思いますね、
ま、エピソードもね追加されて本
当にお二人もね声全部取り直しましたもんね。
そうですね、やっぱもう舞台テレビ声ってもう37年やってますけど、なかなかこう あそこのシーンこうやりたかったなとか必ずねこうお笑いの方でもあると思うんですよね。
こうやり直したいなとかって。
Cool seeing Kiwami 1 and 6 releasing in the same year in Japan.
基本やれないん
です。 That's kind of how it is.
この経験しかこの後もないんだろうなっていうその。
The reason why it takes like a year or two to release it everywhere else is to translate the language and localize it. Because I thought I heard, and I could be wrong on this, I thought I heard like, it's not just the language they change, but it's some of the... in the US, you are officially acknowledged as an adult at the age of 18. And I think in other countries, it's a little different. It's like 16, 14, so on and so forth. And I think in Japan, I think it's something like 14 or 16, something like that. So... whenever, so that's part of the reason why you see like a lot of interactions with teenagers, but obviously there will be people that would be calling like red flags and all this other stuff, and so they have to like localize it from the age of 16 to 18, that sort of thing. So if a character is like 16, they got to change it to 18. So it's not just also like translating the language to English and give like subtitles, but it's also stuff like that. Because obviously, a company doesn't want to, you know, get any like bad publicity, that sort of thing. So, it's also little tweaks like that. I mean, hell, even though I haven't played 3, I thought I heard in 3, in the English version, the original, they actually didn't have hostess bars. If you played the original on PlayStation 3, and I know this from a friend of mine who actually played the original Yakuza 3, and that was decided because they didn't think that the English speaking audience would completely understand hostess bars, cabarets, that sort of thing. So they decided to take all that out. But the problem is, that's actually a lot in Yakuza. So then when they came out with 4, they said, ah, just screw it, just leave it all in there. But for a brief period for 3, they took out hostess bar. And then I could only assume for the remaster, they just put them back in because reasons. Yakuza 3 has outdated combat with Kiryu being overpowered. And the remastered edition is... oh, really?
こちらが2016年12月8日発売龍が如
く。Really, the Yakuza 6 Dragon Engine is a little rough.
こちらキャッチコピーが桐生一馬伝説最終章ということで、まあ、あの桐生さんの物語に一区切りがつけられる作品で、
龍
が
如く3
以来となる単独の主人公でしたね。やっぱりもう最終章ということで。
At the very least, I wouldn't mind just seeing 6 so that way I have reference to Like a Dragon. But of course, obviously, I want to see 3, 4, and 5 also released. I'm also a big wrestling fan, and when I saw that there was a Joshi wrestler in... Yakuza 5, I was like, you son of a bitch. By the way, that was the second character, that was the second Joshi wrestler that ended up in a Yakuza game, and I'm like, god damn it. I would freaking love that. I'm a huge wrestling fan, by the way. So that just furthers my relationship with freaking Yakuza. Because a lot of the moves they do in the game is a lot of wrestling based.
ただ、本当今回、まあそのね、
coming up.
Right.
Have like about 15 minutes left, so I'm hoping that if there is an announcement, it should be soon. We're coming up on the 1 hour 45 minute mark almost. Yakuza 3. Oh, wait, yeah, I already read that. Sorry. I'm just sitting here rambling. And it feels like I'm hardly paying attention to chat. My bad. I'm the worst. Yakuza 6 has amazing pre-rendered cutscenes. Some of the cutscenes are just so good. Hell, I remember talking to a friend of mine, and there is just something about in animes, and sometimes even in Yakuza, these guys know how to do basic framing of a shot, of just like getting like beautiful visuals. They know how to compose a shot to get the right angles and to like have the characters in a certain position to the way they want. It seems like only in animes and in Yakuza sometimes, it just, they know how to compose their shots very well.
まあ連絡は入れたんですけど、もう最初の入ってる5曲っていうのは僕が選ん でここにって言って編集かましたやつの DVD を送りつけたんですよ、事務所に。で、それたまたま。
Swear if it's something about a mobile game, oh dude, if we get news of a mobile game, dude, we all pissed up in here. Every single one of us is gonna be pissed.
まあそこからまあ一応話をさせてもらって。
Dragon Engine did bump up the cinematics. Wonder if there will be an announcement for the rest of the Yakuza. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for, Parky. Yeah, it would be awesome, Sir Dandy, if they did do Ishin and all that. I want to see all the spin-offs, Dead Souls, Ishin, all their spin-offs, all, hell, I would even go as far as, like, Judgment? Give me freaking Judgment to come to PC? Give me, like, dude, I want everything. I want everything. I think in Japan it was called Judgment Eyes. But Ishin, Judgment, Dead Souls, seeing Kanzan a lot. Like, I want all of it. I like to see all of it come to PC. But then again, I also would like to see it to come to every platform. Xbox, Switch, all that. Be freaking great. Yeah, Judgment Eyes is so good. Which, that was another game that I thought I heard had both English and Japanese voice acting, which is pretty freaking cool. Want that locked at 60 frames? Even though I'm on PC, I'm not like that hardcore elitist to where it's like, oh, it has to be like 60 frames or above. I just want the game. I know there's like hardcore elitists to where it's like, oh, if the game's not 60 frames, fuck it. Sometimes people, because at one point 30 frames used to be the standard, but technology just kept got better and better, and some people just kind of stick to basics, and you know, it just happens. As long as I don't have screen tear and other frame rate issues of that nature, I'm fine.
はい、2017年12月7日発売。
There's Kiwami 2.
Kiwami 2です。
So yeah, they've been going down the entire timeline of Yakuza and every game, even the PSP releases, the handhelds. It's been done entirely in Japanese, and you know, I don't understand what they're saying, which is kind of sad. I wish I could sit here and like translate everything for you guys, but I just can't. Just love the series. We all love the series, man. I fell in love with the series with Zero. Zero was my very first Yakuza game, and so far, it's... Here's the thing about Zero with me. It set a standard to every story-based video game I ever played. I thought the RDR1 series... the Red Dead Redemption series, I thought, was like the standard of like good story-based games. And then Yakuza Zero with RRG Studios just said, hold my beer. Like, that's what happened. Hey, Parky, thank you for the sub, man. Thank you for that. Thank you, thank you. Appreciate it. Appreciate that sub. By the way, for those that don't know, I'm on both Twitch and YouTube at the same time, so I know a lot of you guys are showing up on YouTube because I guess it was just easier to find my stream than the original. If anyone does want a link to the original stream that I'm watching, it's also on YouTube. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and do that now, just shits and giggles. But yeah, if you guys want to watch the actual stream, there's a link if you guys want to check it out. So far, to my knowledge, we haven't got any kind of type of information so far. Yakuza Online. Wait, was that the game that had like a whole bunch of like New Japan guys, I think? I actually didn't know that was a thing, Yakuza Online.
はい、現在も好評配信中ということですが、これは本当に、いろんな意味が、あったんですけど、新しい主人公の数が一番っていうのが、龍河ごとくオンラインのがなんと先に出てくる。の上で、同一主人公、同一設定なんだけど、2つの違う話を、2つの作品でやるっていうトライ。Oh, it was a mobile game.
Well, that's probably the reason why a lot of us is not too happy about that. Hey, even though that I know that a lot of you guys are probably played the series on console, which is awesome, and even though that I'm on PC, we can get together and say that mobile is not a real game, right? That's not a real platform, right? We all agree on that? We all agree on that? I know I'm on PC, I know some of you guys are on console, but come on. Mobile's not a real platform. Get that trash out of here. Get your trash out of here. Get a real game, Gant. God damn it. Get a real game. I really want RRG Studios to make a third-person horror game like Siren, Silent Hill, and Fatal Frame. There's part in Yakuza 6 and Judgment where they walk through a dark alley with a flashlight. Interesting. With the dragon engine. That is awesome. I could actually see them doing something really good with that. I think that would be interesting. Not sure how much I'll enjoy it and how much I would want out of it, but it would be interesting. Whenever it comes to like dark settings, like I love just seeing like small detail. Oh, there it is. Yakuza Like a Dragon. Pretty freaking good game, man. But like the lighting in dark areas just looks so good. I remember playing Kiwami 2 and just seeing the lighting reflect off the ground where you see like a damp ground, like there was water but it dried up a little, and seeing a straight up water puddle. Something about that just, it looks so good at night. That's why I like settings at night. You could really like take little bits and pieces of, take like little bits of pieces and like really appreciate the graphics that they did. It's so, so good. Dark Alley event's pretty good. This lighting looks so good. Of course, it's Japanese myth and Western audience ghost. As much as I probably didn't really like the pacing too much in Yakuza 0, I thought Yakuza Like a Dragon had better pacing of the game. They really try and hook you really quick with the story, and I really love that. Why didn't they talk about Judgment Eyes? Isn't it a part of the series too? Love that game. I would love to play that game. I think it's really, really... When I first heard of the game, I thought it was awesome. I was like, a Yakuza game to where they kind of see it from a Yakuza game to where they see it from a... detective's point of view, I thought was awesome. I would love to play it. Judgment, Dead Souls, Ishin. I would love to play all those games. I think it would be so awesome. Now this would be interesting right here, because I know for a fact he's talking about his experience with Yakuza 7, since he's the voice actor that does Ichiban. I would really love to see what he's saying right here if I could, but sadly I don't know the language. I should not just say Ichiban, I should also say Nishiki, because it's the same guy. If you played the Japanese voice acting, this guy's Nishiki / Ichiban. It's the same voice actor. I want to say when he does Nishiki, he's a little bit more tame, but when he's Ichiban, I kind of feel like he's a little bit more like Majima to a degree. He's a little more loud with his voice, and when he really gets to yelling, that's when you hear Nishiki. It's like, when you hear him yell, it's like, oh dude, that is so Nishiki. So Nishiki. Nishiki-yama, dude.
Yeah,
that voice actor is Nishiki right there, on the left. I think to avoid Judgment Eyes is because they don't have the main cast of the game. Maybe. But technically they have the devs that that made it, so I'm sure the devs would probably be able to have something to say about it, but then again, I think the primary focus is on the core series, so that's probably the reason why they're sticking to strictly Yakuza. Because technically, Judgment Eyes, even though it's done in the same universe, it's not necessarily the same. But to us fans, To us, it's cant. To us, it's the same. But... To be fair, strictly, it is Yakuza. But us hardcore fans, we all know that judgment should be in there. We all know that judgment should be in there. Judgment slash judgment eyes. Kind of like turn-based combat more than the beat-em-up style, to be honest. Love Yakuza like a dragon. Even though I disagree, I don't necessarily say that it's a bad thing, because even though that I'm actually the kind of opposite to where I actually kind of prefer the beat-em-up, that's part of the reason why I think we kind of need turn-based is because of that right there. Dandy just said that he actually prefers turn-based combat. So if you're someone that enjoys turn-based combat, you know, you probably would never picked up the game. So that's part of the reason why I actually kind of think they should have like two versions of the game. So that way, if you enjoy turn-based, you could play the Yakuza Like a Dragon series. But if you want the beat-em-up, you could play the Yakuza series, if that makes sense. But even though I preferred the beat-em-up, I wouldn't say the turn-based was all that bad. It was pretty... You could get it down pretty quick. You just gotta kind of just dive in both feet and just have at it.
さあ、今ね、ずっとの目の前にございましたけれども、そちらです。プレイステーションアワーズ。
Oh, really? He's a popular
singer. パートナーアワードで、龍が如くセブンが受賞いたしました。おめでとうございます。
Might not get Judgment Eye 2.
Really? すごいことですよね。受賞できるっていうのは。
そうですね。というか、まあ、振り返ってみると、もういろんなところからいろんな、
I hope there's overtime on this.
それこそ最初の2005年に振り返るともう売れるの売れないのみたいな話をして、
Because it's 2 hours.
たくさんこれから先続けていってその間に、
I hope they leave it on a cliffhanger here.
全く考えてはいなかったので、もう本当に毎回ありがたいし、それこそゲームショーあたりでは、まあ本当ね、司会の方から、まあ、もう本当に理由は
I don't care if they go overtime and they give us something big here.
ちょっと照れくさいですけど、でも本当に毎回ありがたいなとは思ってます。本当に心から今回も感謝しています。
はい、ということで改めておめでとうございます。さあ、それではここでですね、あのユーザーの皆さんからの質問に、お答えしていただきたいと思います。ではここで塩山さん、こんばんは。
はい。
こんばんは。
こんばんは。お願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、I thought I heard this was supposed to be 2 hours. We're at the 2 hour mark.
分出ますかね。
はい。さあ、塩山さんの質問、制作陣への質問ということでしたが。
はい。あ、ごめんなさい。開発期間内で、当初と大きく設定変更など、まあ、あのキャラクター性格など変更したキャラクターはいますでしょうか。
あ、そうですね。構想から発売まで。
はい。
いろいろね時間はありますけども、その経過とともにいろいろ変化したキャラクターとかいるんでしょうか。設定性格だったりビジュアルだったりかな。
そうです、はい。
書いてるうちに大きい役に昇格するとかはあるんですけどね。河野木戸ちゃんとかがそうなんですけど、そのチンピラ B っていう早くからどんどんどんどん喋ってたら、その気取って役になっていったみたいなのはありますけど、できちゃってからどうなんですか、
ね。まあ、確かに話を転がす上でもう一人欲しいよねみたいなところでね、ドイツをこうピックアップしようかみたいなところはあるよね。メインクラスはでもやっぱ最初にカチッとやっぱある程度固めるので、意外と
Judgment still had no karaoke? What? Why did they not have karaoke, man?
ないんじゃないかな。
God damn it, Judgment. By the way, I have not played Judgment, but I so want to play it. I think it would be so good.
One の時に設定していなかったその設定とか裏の性格とか本当はこういう
の。RRG Studios is a AA game company, right? Or is it a AAA company?
だけど
Probably closer to double A. But it might actually be bigger in Japan than it is in the Western audience, to be fair. So in Japan, it might be more of a triple A, but in the US and everywhere else, it's probably closer to an indie title, actually. Wait, what the hell is that? Either... Now, because I don't speak Japanese, either that was our announcement, or she just held up a karaoke disc of some awesome karaoke songs. CD. FT Kasuyan. To my knowledge, this is supposed to be a two-hour show, so they should be wrapping up here. They went over the entire series, so now I'm assuming they're talking about potential future plans. Is this our announcement? That was a soundtrack of Yakuza 5. Selling us more products. They're selling us products, but we all want an announcement. Where is it? Come on, RRG Studios. Why do you put me on a cliffhanger like this? Anyone else feel like you're playing like Yakuza right now? And it's like, you know it's coming. You know it's going to be a good story. And it's like, just deliver. Receive and jebaited you. Nice. Honestly, after we get through all these products, they better be an announcement after this. It's awesome that RRG Studios made better quality games than some. I know, that's the reason why I freaking fell in love with the series and the... That's why I fell in love with the series and the company. Hell, I'm even throwing in freaking Sega in that same boat as well. Props to Sega. Sega, RRG Studios. Oh yeah. They should end this fucking thing with their shirts off on a tower. That's how it's really done around here. Oh, we got freaking like perfume shit. Got spray this product in your hair. I wonder how Kiryu smells like. I mean, hell, we got Kiryu right now spraying on some kind of type of perfume, cologne. Getting a good sniff there. Come on, you two. End this like Kiwami 2. Or no. Kiwami 1. Yeah, it was Kiryu and Nishiki and Yakuza 1 that fought with their shirts off. Come on, just like the game. And then announce our title. Goddamn. はい。うん。本当それぞれね、あの個性のある香りだと思いますので、これからね、プレゼント、クリスマスプレゼントなどにもぴったりだと思いますので、皆さんぜひゲットしてください。はい。さあ、続いてはこちらです。書籍龍大全2龍が如く人物録の発売が決定しました。2021。すごいんですよ。これ本書で。But it's all in Japanese.
7までのナンバリングタイトル8作品と龍が如くオンライン
に
関する人物情報を総まとめしている一冊となっております。
Okay.
サブストーリーに
a whole bunch of stuff in Japanese. I don't know what it says.
スポットで出会うあの人までが掲載されている。
I know, right? 何？
情報量の人物名鑑です。山おろしやメスキングの昆虫など。
Anyone else as confused as I am?
掲載されています。横山プロデューサーのネタバレ OK のお墨付きのもとに制作進行中です。発売は2021年3月19日。
Yeah, it says something for Yakuza Online.
さらにこちらも特別なセットをご用意しました。龍大全2、龍が如く人物
を記念した。We're not getting a whole bunch of text.
セガストアで予約開始となります。
Crap, where's somebody that could translate for us? You son of a bitch! Great, we're probably getting our announcement right here, but ain't no one know what they're saying. Well, if they're going to do an online, you might as well...have every character return. Sega owns RRG Studios and Atlas, right? Yakuza 0 and Persona 5 both made big impact in 2007. True. Very, very true. I'm guessing this is Yakuza Online? Because I think they dialed back the features. Check out these awesome PlayStation 2 graphics.Super ass sweet, look at it. Yakuza Online coming out March 19th. That's all I can think of based off of it's saying online. Okay. I know, right? Sai-chan. And plus, that's the, That's a class you have to unlock after you get to a Bond 5, I think, with her. All I just know is Yakuza Online is mobile game.
Is
that an Xbox logo I'm seeing right there? Did I just see a half-assed Xbox logo? Crossover?
Supported by 龍が如くの開催が決定しております。配信日は12月20日でバーチャルライブ制作プラットフォームリアリティライブステージで開催予定です。
When you look at your own chat and it's like, does anyone else know what you're seeing here? Because I don't. We need that one guy that knows Japanese. Sadly, I'm not the guy.
大人数を動員する音楽ライブの実施が困難になる中湘南の
風はリアリティ
ライブステージが提供
したバーチャ
ルライブを視聴
して But it's technically not over. We still have hope.
龍が如くとの演出をイメージできたことからバーチャルライブを実施すること
になったことです。You need to pray to
your God heart. ライブの
デザイン映像
があるとのことなのでこちらをご覧ください。
DLC?
これどんなライブになるんですかね。ちょっと新しいですもんね。今やっぱり大人数で集まれないですから、みんな遠くにいるかもしれないんですけども、みんなでつながって盛り上げられるライブになってると思います。さあそしてですね、さらに
湘
南の風メンバーの方からもコメントをいただいております。それではこちらをご覧ください。どうぞ。
龍が如く15周年記念特番、ご覧の皆さんこんばんは、湘南の風レッドライスです。
初回です。
15周年おめでとうございます。
おめでとうございます。
15周年だね。
すごいね。
もう一口に言ってもまあ 本当いろいろありますね。
長い歴史、やっぱり龍が如く、うん、まあ僕自身もともと
definitely came off like it、
ね、ゲームをしていた人ですから、うん、やっぱり。
By the way, there was probably some audio I should have、muted there, but I kind of missed the cue.
本当に。
Because we're doing this live, guys. I ain't muting shit.
すごくよくしてもらって、その都度その時々。すごくなんていうかな、ありがたいお話。
I freaking lost. I am too, dude. Don't worry, we could be lost together. It's blind leading the blind who... Something.
なんか龍が如くの思い出とか。
うん、あの、もういっぱいありますよ。そんなの。だって。
To be fair, this could be big news if you're Japanese.
ああいう節目に、本当ね、携わらせていただいてるっていうのがありがたいじゃない？だからこの前の一番かも結局、その主人公が変わ
る。Real fast, I'm just gonna do this as a joke.
そういう龍が如くに。
Someone from this chat, please God, tell me, tell me what I'm seeing here. That's the chat from the actual, actual stream.
結構深い時間まで。
Crap.Now I fucked everything up. My bad. Sorry, I just had to do that as a joke.
なんとか有言実行の方だから、実際にそれをこうやってあの形にしてくださる。その男気がまさに龍が如くの主人公っぽいじゃない。そういうところもすごく学びがあるというか。
Someone please tell us.
そうだね。俺ら湘南の風としてもやっぱ。
I would actually suck if someone from the other chat actually did say something.
ライブでもすごいキーになる曲。
Thanks for making the stream good and interesting for English speaking dudes. I know.
そしてあのその龍が如くねいっぱい曲やってきましたけど一番最新のやつは一番。
But yeah, usually I play Yakuza games, whatever releases for PC anyway.
そのキャラクターたちでついにライブ
することが。But I'm a huge Yakuza fan and.I think I'm going to be playing Cyberpunk on Thursday. I don't know what time I'm going to be doing that, but I'm going to be playing Cyberpunk. I kind of am currently going through Like a Dragon, but I'm going to be holding off on that to do Cyberpunk. I'm going to be streaming every single day for it. It's going to be awesome. I'm going to love it. But any news about Yakuza, I'm open ears. I have a little bit of like a small Yakuza community. Also, some of the guys are into like Persona and all that.I know I played Persona 4 recently. It's a freaking great game. Absolutely loved it. But anyway, because I think this is our announcement right here. Sounds like they have a band coming in for Yakuza Like a Dragon. Sounds like. I'm also holding on to Yakuza 7 until I play Cyberpunk enough. Maybe it'll take a while.The only thing about Cyberpunk that I know with me is I thought I heard it's actually supposed to be shorter than Witcher 3, and I played Witcher 3, casual playthrough, trying to do a little bit of everything as possible. I got 250 hours in Witcher 3. I think it's safe to say.Cyberpunk is going to be shorter. I don't think there's going to be a 250 hours of content, DLC and all. I'm thinking the expansion packs is going to like fill in Cyberpunk. But I'm super excited to see what Cyberpunk has for me. So I'm going to be diving into that.If anyone's curious to see that playthrough, I am curious to see what some of your guys' playthrough ends up being like. But just like with you, just like with me, stay away from spoilers. You don't say shit until the other person says where they're at. But yeah, I love hearing about like what some of you guys are like going through. Because like One question I did thought of for Yakuza Like a Dragon was like, in your guys' playthrough, did you Your first playthrough, did you do English or Japanese voice acting? But yeah, I think that was our announcement. Oh, and it looks like PlayStation 5 is also getting Yakuza Like a Dragon. But if you already have it, you already played it, so what's the point? Unless updated graphics for PlayStation 5, so console guys got to get PlayStation 5 for the better graphics. Yeah, they said Cyberpunk is shorter than Witcher 3 because not many people finished the Witcher 3 for being too long. I see why. It took me 250 hours on a single playthrough, DLC and all, trying to do a little bit of everything. 250. That's what I have in Witcher 3, so it's freaking long. So I can see why they would want to do like a shorter game and just fill it with probably like expansion packs. But yeah, I'm super looking forward to Cyberpunk, seeing what that's all about. Also, if anyone is a fan of Persona, Persona 5 Strikers is coming to PC and PlayStation, I believe, in February. So any Persona fans out there, I think we're kind of booked for February. For those that don't know, Persona 5 Strikers is a lot like Persona 5 Scramble, I believe. In Japan, I think they call it Scramble, and in Western audience, they're calling it Strikers. So any Persona fans out there, that's one tidbit for you. Sorry you came to a Yakuza stream and got Persona 5 information. That's all in my Discord, and I think up on my Twitter about that. The man that needs no introduction. Freaking Kiryu over here. I'm excited for Strikers, and I'm happy it's coming to the West. I know, right? Dude, same. Same. I remember thinking, dude, fourth quarter of 2020, like, we have so many great games coming out, or is already out. We got Persona 4, if anyone, like, wanted to see that come to PC. Like, I played Persona 4 Golden. It was awesome. Absolutely loved it. Highly recommend it. Of course, you guys on console probably already played it and know what it's like. Persona 4 Golden, I think, was actually for a handheld, so... anyway. What did they announce? It appears to be a soundtrack, possibly added content DLC for Yakuza Like a Dragon, coming in 2021. Also, Yakuza Like a Dragon is coming to PlayStation 5 in 2021. It looks like that's the announcement that we have. So they gave us something. We just didn't get what we... Come on. Show of hands. How many people wanted a new game? New game, new announcement, new platform, something of that nature. I know I'm in the PC crowd, so... I guess I gotta wait. Yeah, I gotta wait longer for Yakuza 3, 4, and 5 announcement. It will come eventually, it's just taking its precious freaking time. Persona 5 Scramble, ain't it? Not Striker? It's the same thing. It's... So, like, Ryo Gotoku is Yakuza, so it will be like saying that. RRG Studios named Yakuza after themselves, or whatever in Japan. In Japan, Yakuza is not called Yakuza, it's called Ryogotoku, which is, in translation, like a dragon. So it was actually kind of awesome when they released Yakuza 7 and called it Yakuza Like a Dragon, because it was reference to the original name. So, there you go. But yeah, it's... Persona 5 Scramble is Persona 5 Striker. Same thing. Same thing. Hopefully that clarified everything. My dumb American brain can't process information correctly. Persona 3 Remake, please save! Oh, I just want everything! Oh my god, Persona 3 Remake? I'll take it. I'll take it. Persona 3? Persona 3 Remake? I played Persona 4 Golden. Freaking awesome, great game. But yeah. Also, for those that are playing Persona Strikers, Persona 5 Strikers, did anyone else get the realization? Did Yakuza and Persona just switch games? We had a beat 'em up, and now all of a sudden we're getting turn-based, and then with Persona, we got a turn-based, and then, you know, let's go in more of like a beat 'em up, except it's going to be more of a hack and slash. No one will notice the difference. There you go. Yeah, I'm guessing a lot of you guys are probably gonna GTFO after this, so. Which is fine. I was actually thinking about ending the stream afterwards, but I think I'll play a little bit more of Yakuza Like a Dragon, I think. Just what the hell. We'll go ahead and do a little bit of Yakuza Like the Dragon. I'm in Chapter 7 on my English playthrough. Second playthrough, by the way. But yeah, I appreciate everyone that hung out with me for a little bit. Sorry that we didn't get the information that we all wanted. Either a new game or perhaps a new release on a new platform. We didn't get that, but... Don't... I mean, just like what Kiryu would tell you, don't be down, be positive. Be positive, have your hopes up. Look forward to the future. It will happen. You dream hard, it will happen. Be with me. Come on, guys. You gotta be like Fighter. Goddamn Fighter has been working the game for fucking ages now. He used to be at that freaking RC race car, the freaking pocket circuit racing. He went on to freaking like go-karts. Let's do it, guys. Let's do it. Let's all be Fighter. Be positive. Keep hoping. Go be yourself, exactly. All you console guys who want a new game, go out there and, you know, preach to RRG Studios. We want a new game. We want to see new games, dude. Give us new games. Everyone like me who wants to see it on every platform, go out and preach. Everyone's got to read the scriptures. Preach to the Bible. We want it on all platforms. Every single... We want the entire series. Do that hard enough, it will happen. And maybe someday this game will be the biggest freaking series in all the world. And then it would tell freaking Rockstar, this is how you make real games, bitch. And it's like, there you go. Yeah, I think they're wrapping up over here. I was really hoping. Arb and facts, I know. I try my best, but I'm only preaching to a block of myself. I'm just walking up and down the street. Hear ye, hear ye!
We all want new game Yakuza and shit. You know, give us. I mean, hell, let's go a step further. Give us Persona 6. How about that? There you go. Persona 5 on all platforms. Yakuza on all platforms. Friggin', let's do it. Let's march to the streets.
I gotta go, buddy. I'll get the news on Twitter anyway. Well, thanks, man. Thanks, Journey Vids, for hanging out with me. Thank you for stopping by. Hopefully I see you again, but if not, that's okay, too. But thanks, man, for hanging out with me. Sorry we didn't get the news. And by the way, guys, if you ever get news of, like, there's going to be, like, some kind of type of conference, I would be more than happy to do this again. So if you guys can't find the, like, actual stream, I would love to restream it for you guys. So that way, if you ever, oh, hey, what happened on this such and such stream? You could just come to, like, my channel and, like, check it out. Or come to my channel and see if I know any information on potential streams and stuff. Twitter, Discord, if you guys want to get any news or information about that stuff, I'd love to see you guys again, but you guys gotta go. Hey, we all have our own lives. It's all good. But I think I will be doing some Yakuza Like a Dragon, just to kind of like mess around, screw around, do whatever. Yeah, so I think they're wrapping up here.
Thank you, arigatou gozaimashita.
Thank you,
Shenshe.
You hate to see it happen. You hate to see it happen. Shit! Yeah, that was it. God damn it! We didn't get the information. Well, there you go. Unless they have a secret. Do we have to look at Twitter? Fuck! We gotta look at Twitter. Hey, I'm leaving.